Hi folks, welcome to another new edition of Developer Insight. It has been quite some time that we had not done a Developer Insight video. So here we go. Let's look at some of the statistics that are available as far as the artificial intelligence, generative AI, machine learning and LLM, that is large language models that have been in the rage for quite some time now. Let's start by looking at some of the market statistics. As per the recent available data, in 2024, the artificial intelligence market worth is somewhere around $207 billion. And by 2027, it is going to be somewhere around $267 billion. If you look at the growth, year-on-year growth, compounded way, it is almost 9.33%, almost 10% of growth year-on-year. And I think there is no other market and field which is growing at this aggressive rate right now. And by 2030, they are saying that it is going to be almost $15.7 trillion worth of contribution to the global economy. So there is no doubt as far as the importance the artificial intelligence and machine learning is going to play in the coming years. It's not future, it's happening right now. Now, when it comes to the job market, these are the sum of the average salaries in US right now for the various roles. And if you look at the top 8 roles, out of those 8 roles, 6 are related to artificial intelligence. Not only that, even the roles which are in the bottom half, out of those 3 are still related to artificial intelligence and machine learning. So there is no doubt that this field is exploding and the job market is going to be hot for this particular domain for quite some time. We don't know when it is going to stop, but as of now, it looks like it is not stopping anytime soon. So I'm pretty sure a lot of us are thinking about how do I pivot towards artificial intelligence if I want to make best use of this opportunity? What are the potential opportunities? What are the skill sets that are required to flourish in this particular field? What theoretical knowledge is required? What are the hands-on practical skills that are required? Not only that, how much time and effort it is required to master these skills? These are very, very relevant questions that anybody would ask who wants to explore career in this field. So let's spend some time understanding what are the various different roles that are available in the market in the domain of AI or generative AI, machine learning or LLM put together overall. So these are the very common roles that I have come across. You may not find these exact designations in companies as such because these are not the real designations, but these are basically the different roles that are available in the space of generative AI or machine learning. I have basically arranged it in the pyramid way to indicate that if you can start at the bottom of the pyramid and move up towards the top end of the pyramid, you are basically moving from the very easy to conquer skill sets to more niche skill sets as you move up the ladder from one step to another step. Needless to say that as you move up, the number of skill sets that you have to acquire would also be more, and it would also require more time. So what we will do is we will try to understand what are the theoretical knowledge that would be required and what are the practical hands-on skills that would be required in each of these roles. And not only that, we would like to understand how much time does it take to acquire these skills, because that's also very, very important. The people who are looking at this particular video might come with very diverse experience. There might be a college graduate who just has started or wants to start his career in this domain, or there are already people who are decently experienced in the IT field, in the software engineering field, and they are either DevOps engineers or front-end engineers or mobile application engineers, and this is something that interests them. Or it might be someone who is already well experienced enough and wants to pivot towards a new domain that looks interesting. So without much further ado, let's start with AI application developer. That is the very bottommost one. Now, let me explain you what is the typical work that you will be doing here. You already have some kind of a LLM deployed somewhere, and they have exposed it through APIs, nothing but REST APIs, and you want to consume those APIs to develop applications which leverage the LLMs. The theoretical knowledge to be able to do this is you should be able to know how to do the REST API integration. You should have some very basic understanding of artificial intelligence, what is machine learning, what is deep learning. You should have some understanding of basic algorithms that are typically used here. And then you will have to be a front-end developer, knowing how to integrate the REST API with a front-end. The front-end could be a mobile application or a web application. So you have to be familiar with something like React and JavaScript. And of course, you need to be familiar with Python, because Python is the preferred language when it comes to AI field. And what are the hands-on skills? Those are programming in Python. You should understand what is the artificial intelligence service integration look like, how to deploy your AI applications. There are various services that are available, like Heroku, AWS, Azure, OpenAI, and not only that, interact with your models. There are things like embeddings, tokenization. You should be familiar with those concepts to be able to do this. And if you are wondering how much time would it take to develop these kind of skills, if you are already a very decent developer who has done some kind of a REST API integration and is familiar with JavaScript, all those things, it's just a matter of learning Python and related frameworks. So I would say somewhere around 3 to 6 months to get the theoretical knowledge, and another 3 to 6 months to get the practical hands-on. So within 6 to 7 months, you should be able to develop small applications in this layer of the opportunities. Next comes the data analyst. Once again, in this layer, it goes a little bit up in terms of the skills from the layer below, that is AI application developer. In terms of theoretical knowledge, you should have your good understanding of statistics, probability, hypothesis testing, regression analysis, all those things. Not only that, you should have a very good grip on data visualization principles and things like basic machine learning models like linear regression, logistic regression, k-means clustering, all those things. That is the theoretical knowledge. Now, when it comes to practical knowledge, of course, Python is going to be the major part, and not only that, you should be familiar with how to work with the SQL, NoSQL, data manipulation and visualization. Then you will have to be familiar with frameworks like Pandas, NumPy, and to be able to do the data analysis. There are things like Matplotlib, C, Borg, to be able to do the data manipulation and visualization. And in terms of the effort that would be required, I would say around 6 to 9 months to get the theoretical knowledge, and almost 6 to 12 months to get the practical knowledge. So you can do it hand in hand together to reduce the overall effort to be able to do these things in 1 year. Not master, but to just to get grip on things. Then comes the machine learning engineer. Data analyst just does a lot of data processing, sanitization of the data to be used by the machine learning engineer to basically train the models. So in terms of the skill sets, it is little bit above. So you should have a very deep understanding of machine learning algorithms. You should have a proper understanding of data processing, model evaluation, and optimization, because the data models, whenever they are trained, they will not give you immediate result what you want. So you should know exactly what is happening inside to some extent, how to tweak the things to get the desired results from your data models. And in terms of hands-on skills, once again, Python is the thing to go. And then there are a lot of machine learning libraries. There are frameworks like TensorFlow, PyTorch that are used to do the machine learning. Then you should have a very good understanding of how to do the machine learning model deployment. So involving containerization with the Docker, using the model serving tools like TensorFlow and the TorchServe. And there are a lot of cloud platforms which are providing machine learning services. You should have a very good understanding of what are those services, AWS, GCP, Azure. It's very, very important that you learn these things and take your time to get a proper understanding of how to orchestrate these different services and different frameworks to be able to get a proper working solution. And in terms of the effort, I would say it is slightly more because you will have to learn a lot of things compared to data analyst. So I would say around one and a half year of effort that would be required to learn machine learning engineer role related skill sets. Then comes the AI research scientist. This is, I would say, more of a academic role where people are doing PhDs, learning specialization in the artificial intelligence, machine learning, artificial neural network, those kind of things. So it really requires a lot of advanced mathematics calculus, linear algebra, probabilistic decision making. Then there are theoretical foundations of neural networks itself, like architecture, activation functions, how does the forward and backward propagation work, what are the optimization algorithms. And not only that, you will have to actively contribute towards the research community in this particular field. That is about the theoretical knowledge. And then there is practical knowledge. You should have a very good understanding of machine learning algorithms, implementation of machine learning algorithms, of course, using once again done with Python. Then there are concepts like architecture design, specifically for orchestrating the AI applications. Concepts like hyperparameter tuning, training on specialized hardwares like GPUs and TPUs, all those things. So this is very, very serious stuff. And this is not something that engineer who has already been in industry and now suddenly want to pivot can try to achieve it. But if somebody who is in very nascent stage of his student life, this is something that you can aspire for because it takes time. People do PhDs in this field to be referred to as a scientist. So I would say almost around 3 to 4 years to be able to get to this particular level. This is not something that suddenly one day you will rise and say that I want to become an AI research scientist. It can't be done overnight. But AI application developer, you can attempt to do that. Not overnight, but at least in a couple of months, if not weeks, you should be able to get your skill set to a level where you can start developing AI applications. Then comes next specialization, which is Gen AI specialist or generative AI. This is a very special niche subsection under the artificial intelligence, where you are trying to use artificial intelligence to create generative models like GANs or VAEs. You are basically trying to develop applications in generating new data instances. You will have to work with neural network optimization for generative tasks. You need to have a proper understanding of techniques for training and optimizing the neural networks specifically for generative tasks, including dealing with issues like mode collapse in GAN. And when it comes to practical hands-on skill, it goes one layer above than just being familiar with the machine learning algorithms. You will have to understand how to set up and train the models like GANs and VAEs, including you will have to play a role of a data scientist because you will have to do the data preparation. You will have to model the architecture design. Then you will have to train those models. So you will have to basically come up with the procedures for training your models and implementing the architecture, customizing and experimenting with the different neural network architectures to improve the model performance and generate a very high quality output. That is very, very important. And then not only that, you should be able to validate whether your models are giving the solutions or results in a way that is expected. Because most of these models are like black boxes. Most experts also don't know how they are able to come up with the solutions that they are coming up. So you should be able to pretty much get your hands dirty by changing the various parameters and getting the desired results from the models that you are trying to train. In terms of the effort, I would say it is pretty similar to a AI research scientist, but so somewhere around 3 years, that much effort is required. When I say these many years, I am basically talking about doing this full time from morning to evening, putting at least 8 hours of effort on daily basis. That is the kind of effort that I am talking about. If you are already a working professional, then you will have to recalibrate these numbers as per how much time you have and how much bandwidth and capacity you have. Now let's go to the next role, which is LLM expert, that is large language model expert. These are nothing but your ChatGPT. So here, when it comes to theoretical knowledge, the concepts that you need to be mastering are natural language processing concepts, that is how to process a natural language, including there are things like tokenization, stemming, lemmatization, part of speech tagging, and then there are transformer model architectures. You should have a very detailed knowledge of transformer models, attention mechanisms, and their advantages over previous models like RMNs, CNNs for the language tasks, and stability in the large language models. There are challenges and strategies in the training large language models. And of course, there are computational requirements. You will have to select the data, and there will be inherent biases sometimes introduced in the system based on the data that you are using to train your large language models, because ultimately these are language models. People will be interacting with them in the natural language. You know what happened with the Google. If you train with a bias, then you will get a very biased output. And when it comes to tactical knowledge, you will have to be very good with Python, of course, because across all these different roles, Python is pretty much the most preferred programming language. Other than that, you will have to be familiar with libraries like Hugging Face transformers for working with pre-trained large language models, including fine-tuning of specific tasks. And you should be able to handle the complexities of training large models, managing the data, managing the compute resources, and deploying the models for real-world applications. And finally, you should be able to develop LLM applications, that is designing and developing applications where you are actually leveraging the large language models for tasks such as text generation, summarization, translation, generating images, and nowadays even videos, as you have seen recently with OpenAI's Sora. To reach this level, once again, you would need a very similar experience of around 2.5 to 3 years to get to a level where you can flourish in this particular role. And then comes the last layer, that is AI ethical advisor. Here, of course, you need to be an engineer. You should have worked quite extensively developing, architecting, designing, deploying these different kind of machine learning, artificial neural network, AI applications. You should have a very solid engineering grip on this. But other than that, here you are basically now playing a role of not just an engineer. You are now basically interacting with various different global organizations, governments, multiple NGOs who are concerned with a lot of ethical dilemmas that are coming out of the new AI field that is exploding. So you should have a very good understanding of philosophical ethics, emerging technology awareness, risk assessment. You should have to interact with the governments and various organizations for the policy formulation and advocacy. So I would say this role is not only an engineering role, it is also a kind of a role that requires legal acumen and philosophical ethics acumen to be able to play in this particular role. And I would say, once again, it would require around 2 to 3 years to be able to reach this particular level. I have definitely seen people who have spent their almost whole life in this particular field, 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, who have now reached a level where they can play some kind of a constructive role in this particular layer. So this is what I think is various roles and skill sets that are associated with those roles, and how much time would it require to develop those skill sets to reach that particular role. So do let me know what do you think, and if you have any questions, just comment down and be part of the conversation. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.